We're going to go ahead and get started with the presentation. First of all, I want to thank everybody for being here. My name is Doug Wilson. I'm with the City of Cedar Rapids, the Paving for Progress Program Manager. And this project we're going to be talking about is on 3rd Avenue from basically 5th Street to 19th Street. Paving for Progress is paying for some ceiling on the project, and then other funding is coming in to pay for the reconfigure of the ration of the roadway from one-way to two-way. Want to introduce the staff that's here today also, and our design consultants. I'll start with Jennifer here.
I'm Jennifer Selby. I'm the project manager for this project.
Seth Gunnarsson. I'm a planner in the Community Development Department.
Gavin with the Community Development Department.
Hello, Emily Green with the City Communications Team.
John Witt with Traffic Engineering.
Mike Kirk, Construction Engineering.
My name is Nick Correa. I'm a project coordinator with the city.
Michaela LeClaire with Anderson Boger. I'm a project engineer on the project.
I'm Jeff Morrow with Anderson Boger Engineers, and I'm a project manager.
Thank you, everyone, and thank everyone here tonight for taking the time out and come talk to us. So the format, we have the same thing at every table. We're going to give a presentation here, 5:30 to 5:45 or so. We'll come. We have staff members that will talk to you at each table. Go through any further comments that we have about the plan. And about 6:20, we'll then report back to the group, and at 6:30, the meeting will be over. So the city vision on conversions. We're not really here to talk about whether or not we're going to do the conversion. The city has done a lot of outreach on this throughout town, through the years, starting in 2015, I think the first time was when we were in this neighborhood talking about the conversions. But I think it's important to remember that these conversions are just going back to the way the street was originally when they were laid out, when these were neighborhoods. And that's what the feedback that council gets, the feedback we get from people is we want these to feel more like neighborhoods. In 1958, when they converted these to one-way traffic, the situation was totally different. We had post-war growth on the northeast side, on the southeast side, on the southwest side. Growing out from the center, the only way you could get downtown, which was the commercial hub of the city and the working hub of the city with manufacturers and where you shopped, was through either the east side of downtown or the west side of downtown. So at that point in time, they said, hey, we'll make 2nd and 3rd Avenue one-way pairs so we can move a lot of traffic through this city, through this area, so we can get people downtown to shop, so we can get people to their jobs like at Penford and at Wilson Foods and at Quaker, because we need this capacity. Well, over time, things have changed, obviously, quite a bit. Not necessarily always for the better, but the way traffic patterns are have changed significantly since that was done. We have the interstate. We have a change in the type of businesses in the downtown area, and those needs for those one-way pairs aren't there anymore. We've already done 2nd Avenue. We're finishing up 3rd Avenue. We want to make sure it's consistent for everybody to get through the town. You know as well as I do, who've lived here for a long time, some of the complaints you would hear would be from people out of town, I can't get anywhere because I can't understand these one-way streets. You do hear that, but hopefully with these one-way conversions, this area is going to feel more like your neighborhood, which is what the original intent was. Well, that's why we have all this single-family housing from 10th Street out to 19th Street, because it's a pedestrian neighborhood where you want people to walk, you want people to bicycle, you want people to use it that way. It also encourages slower traffic speeds, obviously having head-to-head traffic, just one lane each direction. I've lived out on the southeast side, grew up on the southeast side. It's very easy to get going fast on 3rd Avenue. It used to be the same way on 2nd Avenue, going downtown in that middle lane. It almost felt like you were on a freeway a little bit. Not quite, but it's very easy to speed. You slow down the traffic a lot, and that's also going to help make it feel more like a neighborhood and make it safer for everybody who walks and bicycles in the neighborhood. So this is the 6th meeting we've had here in Wellington Heights. The first one was back in 2015, and we've had various letters, open houses, and guest presentations over time. And the time since we met back in January, right before that, we met with the Wellington Heights Association group, and we also met with the HPC Historical Preservation Commission, because there are some people who are concerned about changes to the historical nature of the neighborhoods. We wanted to make sure we touched base with those folks about what we were proposing. So improvements, we'll have a new surface. That'll be sealing the surface of this roadway. That's one way to extend the life of the street so we don't get it to the point where it needs extensive repairs. One-way to two-way conversions. 19th Street, we're gonna transition to a four-way stop versus a signal. Bike lanes, we'll have accessible ramps at every corner. Maintain or add actually a little bit of on-street parking. And then intersection changes at 16th, 17th, and Ridgewood Terrace. What we've heard from residents, 19th signal removal, feedback in favor and opposed. Cul-de-sac transition, we've heard both in favor and opposed. Roundabout option, feedback both neutral and opposed. And then once again, some general feedback looking forward for us to be done with the project and have this one way all complete in this part of town. So integrating the resident feedback at 15th Street. This was what we brought back in January. This is what we're gonna do. We're gonna leave it alone at this point in time. We're gonna keep it as is. We're going to look at the real reason you would do a roundabout here is to slow traffic down a little bit more through the neighborhood. That's a long way between 10th and 19th that you don't have anything to slow your traffic down a little bit. But it will be looked at it once again and will operate just fine without a roundabout there. And it is a little less change. There is quite a bit of pedestrian crossings here. We did see that there has been some pedestrian injuries at that intersection. So as with anything that we do, we'll continue to monitor this corridor as we go through this change to see if there's something we need to do to improve safety. So here's the initial concept at 16th Street. So what we're going to do, we had a lot of feedback that don't close 16th Street off. We really need that open. We were concerned about the way it's currently configured, these two ways in to right that might be confusing for traffic how to get out of here. So 16th will remain open as a right out only, and then Grand Avenue, you'll be able to cross. So this will not be cut off at all. We looked at some other configurations. As a staff, our main concern always is, can we get pedestrians, bicycles, and cars through these intersections cleanly and safely? That's the most important thing that we as engineers look at. We want to make sure this is safe for the traveling public. So that's what we're doing on 16th Street. We will still proceed with converting Park Avenue to two-way. We did extensive research on this section of roadway after we heard about the accidents. Like we went through, we couldn't find a time when there was a fatality. We did find the resolution when they converted it to one-way. It was in 1982. And then in 1992, there were notes from staff attending a neighborhood association meeting talking about two children being hit here on this section of roadway coming out of the park. One of the things that was discussed was going back to two-way to slow people down, doing some other things possibly, and taking parking off this side. So what we're going to do is we're going to leave it. No parking along the park side, so you should be able to see kids coming this way. And as I said before, that two-way traffic, having a car coming both ways, will help people slow down a little bit, because just like any other one-way road, that's nice and wide to go a little bit faster on. So two-way traffic should slow that down. So we feel like we improve access in this area by making that two-way. There's a lot of cars usually parked on both sides here, so it's not fast going down here. One of the things we heard about was access to Johnson. That's two-way. You still can access Johnson right here. You'll still be able to access Johnson here if you're coming off of 3rd Avenue. The only thing that you wouldn't be able to do is turn right and come down 16th. You'll just have to come down 17th. So access to Johnson, we feel like we've addressed in the comments. Initial concept on 17th. We're just going to cul-de-sac it off. We didn't have any details. We looked extensively again at this to how to safely get people through the intersection. Could we do something like we proposed here? Would that make sense? Do we need two lanes out of here? What can we do? We looked at a number of different layouts and looked at the traffic numbers. Remember, we're talking about 1 to 200 cars a day, if even, most days on 17th and Ridgeway. So we're talking about, two cars an hour or so, basically. I'm sorry, 20 cars an hour or so, basically. So it's not a whole heck of a lot of traffic. So what we decided to do was go ahead and continue with the cul-de-sac. We will allow, the traffic's still going to be able to transition from 17th to Blake. There will be a slip right turn here to get you onto the 3rd Avenue nicely. We did talk to the police, too, about concerns about additional criminal activity, as one of the people were concerned about at these cul-de-sacs. The liaison for the neighborhood association we talked to said, no, that should be a problem. They'll be wide open. They're easily seen from 3rd Avenue. And he felt like even just having that cutoff just kind of makes it more difficult if you're chasing someone or if you have to do that, that it really wasn't a big concern for them that they would see an uptick of criminal activity in those areas. So we did listen. We do hear what you were saying and try to come up with solutions for the problems. And then the initial concept here at Ridgeway was the cul-de-sac. Also, we looked at, once again, as many different types of intersections we could build here to make it safe when 3 cars are there, possibly, so you can clearly understand who has the right-of-way or who has the pedestrian right-of-way, because where those 3 streets meet, it's not easy to make that clear. So we did continue, once again, with the cul-de-sac here. You can transition nicely from 18th across. Folks we've actually heard from, at least one member or one person on Ridgeway Terrace that wasn't upset about cul-de-sacking their street because they felt like they got heavy traffic from the cut through to 19th. So not that that's why we would do it. We're just trying to create a situation where it can be safe for all users, pedestrians, bicyclists, and cars. And that's what we're attempting to do while incorporating your views into our final decisions today. So that's what I've got today. Staff will be here to collect additional comments and follow up with residents. The email is available. And I just want to, once again, thank you for your time today.